on this edition of Kababayan Today, a sneak peek of the trailer for Manny the Movie, Arnell the Magician, and regular recipes from Mitsuo Marketplace. That's all next on Kababayan Today.
Sa inyong lahat. Ako po si G. Tonji, and thank you for watching Kababayan Today. We have a very exciting show coming up next week that I want to tell everybody about. Exclusive po yan dito sa Kababayan Today. Makakausap po namin si Ryan Moore, the director and producer of the film Manny, about who else but Manny Pacquiao. It's coming out next week, so we'd like to show you a trailer and a snippet of the interview that we have with Ryan Moore. Let's take a look.
When I was a boy, I had to fight to feed my family.
My entire life, I fought to survive.
Boxing was my only hope.
Manny Pacquiao has been in the sport for 20 long years. He is an 8-time world champion and will someday be in the Boxing Hall of Fame. He fought in this era's most exciting fights, bringing an aggressive, risk-taking style that made every fight a drama in itself. He knows the ruthlessness of boxing better than anyone.
Manny Pacquiao's first loss since 2005.
If you're a fighter, truly a fighter, then you get back up. You fight again.
I don't care who it is, he'll get in there with anybody. And he just comes out with this big smile and he's just waving at everybody and it's like,
I always said, you never know when the next Muhammad Ali is going to walk to your door. Manny Pacquiao is the best thing that ever happened to me.
So, Ryan, why Manny Pacquiao? Out of all the subjects you could have done, what led you to do a film about him?
Well, when I first saw him fight, I was really intrigued because he was fearless in the ring. But at the same time, there was this tremendous humility about him. Hmm. And to me, I thought, it's a strange combination because you don't see a guy who goes in there and completely destroys their opponents and then hugs them after and is like, and then prays and kneels down. And you see all these different things and you wonder, what happened to him in his life to make him who he is? You know what I mean? Because you have a lot of outlandish, you have a lot of outspoken guys in the ring who are banging their chests and they're, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And they're so aggressive, but with Manny, he's a soft-spoken, very sweet guy, and you wonder, in his childhood, all you know, what were the events that occurred to make him this very spiritual, very faith-driven guy? Mm-hmm. And that's what I wanted to find. I wanted to go to the Philippines to find the roots of his life, the people around him, and I wanted to discover all these unique events that haven't been told from him in his voice. Because that's what I wanted to share. And I knew there was an inspiring story behind that.
Yeah, well, you spent a lot of time with him, following him around everywhere to make this film a reality. Talk to us about what really went into making this film as a filmmaker.
Well,
was there a script?
No.
There was absolutely no script.
No. And that's how I wanted it, because I wanted to start without any preconceived notions. I wanted Manny to tell me his side of the story. So I didn't want to come with a script and say, this is what the story's going to be. I wanted to allow it to develop into what it should be, and that's through his voice.
Well, I'm sure that must be very challenging because you're literally there every single day, not knowing where the story will go, mm-hmm. and just filming and filming and filming. So talk to us. How much time did you spend on this project? I know you said 5 years of putting it together, but really, did you have a life?
No,
I didn't. In those 5 years? I mean,
This was my life.
Yeah.
And I spent, as you said, 5 years, and I filmed over 1,200 hours of footage.
That is, I mean, to just imagine having to go through that, mm-hmm. and sit down and go through that must have been a very big challenge.
And the thing is, I had to watch it all.
You shot it, and then you had to watch
it. And you have to watch, and then you have to take notes, and you have to remember, okay, in this year, this happened, because as we keep filming, other things happen and you have to go back and remember, oh yeah, that's right, that happened. And so I credit a lot of that to my editing team. I had an amazing editor, several editors. But you know, when you're working with this much footage and you're working with a guy who is life is constantly evolving and changing. The story keeps changing.
Yes.
And so as a result, we went through so many different versions of the film. It was so hard to lose so many scenes that happened because, you know, you can only fit so much in 90 minutes, right?
Yeah, but Ryan, why not make it a series? Make it, you know, part one, part two, part three. I'm sure you have so much footage that you could actually do that.
Yeah, you know, I'm hoping the Mayweather fight will happen so that I can view some of this footage, you know, in that. But it's been a long journey, and I think that with the way it turned out, it turned out the way it was supposed to be. You know what I mean? Mm. And year two, I thought, oh, I know the story. This is what it's going to be. And then year three, you go, oh, wait a minute. No, that's not the story. And you keep going.
It's bigger than boxing. It's bigger than being a prize fighter. His journey now is about fighting and winning for a people. Huge burden. He accepts it.
Why do I box? Why do I fight? It's God's will.
Ilalabas na po yung pelikula na yan next week, so please mark your calendars. At pagbalik natin dito sa Kababayan Today, it's all about magic with Arnel. Don't go away, we'll be right back.